By not trying to ride the line between demographics, Fantastic Mr. Fox actually satisfies both the young and the old.
Canada be damned. I'm going to the Klondike.
The Klondike is Canada.
Giorgio, you be doing just fine, brother.
Animation, or stop-motion animation, is by no means my go-to. Yet when it aims to target an audience older than adolescents, it can be just as entertaining and valuable as any other live action. Obviously, a blanket title like calling it a family movie can cover all ages. And even though Fantastic Mr. Fox is based on a book by renowned children's author Roald Dahl, certain small details feel unquestionably adult. Even so, the overall charm of Fantastic Mr. Fox will make you feel like a kid again. Before we dig into that, a little background on Fantastic Mr. Fox. In the earth tones of the autumn season, Fantastic Mr. Fox is the story of a fox that's not only fantastic, but exceptional.
You really are kind of a quote-unquote fantastic fox.
Am I getting better, Coach?
Well, you sure as cuss not getting any worse.
Really? I mean, you think I could end up being as good as my dad if I keep practicing?
Your dad? Your dad was probably the best whack bat player we ever had in this school. No, you don't want to have to compare yourself to that.
Settled into family life, Mr. Fox yearns for one last opportunity to step into his former, dangerous ways. Devising a daring three-pronged plan, he decides to steal from three local farmers. Hoping to keep it on the down low, Mr. Fox underestimates his victims, and the fallout is one which spills over to affect the rest of the animal kingdom. Fantastic Mr. Fox is a Wes Anderson film, and even though it isn't live action, it still carries on the traditions of any other Wes Anderson film. From the symmetrical composition to the top-tier ensemble, Fantastic Mr. Fox still feels like a Wes Anderson film. On a few occasions, it does remind the audience of its source material. It may seem like these two are strange bedfellows, but actually, Fantastic Mr. Fox proves this is a match made in heaven. Perhaps the most prevalent reason I wanted to cover this film is the title character. Although we are talking about animation, don't be fooled. There's as much strong character development as your everyday live action. Mr. Fox is a mixed bag. Sure enough, he can be mischievous, as is the nature of foxes.
I'm supposed to cover this book party at some animal's nest in a tobacco field down the hill, so me and Kylie are going to hop over there and give it a whirl. Don't wait up.
What's the book?
Some memoir. I'll get him to sign you a copy. Dinner was pitch perfect. What's that?
What?
I think it's a fox trap.
Where?
Look at this.
No, get away from there.
Is it spring-loaded? Yeah. Yeah, I guess if you come from over there and you're standing at this door to the squab shack, this little gadget probably triggers the...
What?
Move out of the way, darling. That's right where it's gonna land.
Don't. Let's go.
No, it just falls straight right down. Whew. I guess it's not spring-loaded.
Yet, he does have his moments of compassion and tenderness, which are undoubtedly human.
I promise you, if I had all this to do over again, I'd have never let you down. It was always more fun when we did it together anyway. I love you, Felicity. Did I ever tell you about the time I learned we were going to have a cub? I kept wondering, who is this little boy going to be? Ash. I'm so glad he was you.
Above all of these is the identity crisis he's going through. With more years behind him than before him, Mr. Fox is struggling to keep his wild side at bay. A yearning to his animalistic nature is calling him, and he feels compelled to answer the call.
Who am I? And how can a fox ever be happy without you'll forgive the expression, a chicken in its teeth? I think at the end of the day, I'm just...
I know. We're wild animals.
I guess we always were.
He knows it's risky. He knows the consequences. And he knows who it will upset. Still, he must do it because of his ego, and because he is exceptional. Although Mr. Fox says he cannot help himself, due to him being a fox, one cannot help but wonder if this is merely an excuse because the animals have the intelligence, lifestyle, and society that's similar to humans. So where and when do the animal instincts kick in? Maybe I'm reading into this too much. What I feel can't be read into too much is the way in which Fantastic Mr. Fox is a family film. I don't mean that in the sense that a whole family can watch and enjoy it, but rather that there's an individualistic appeal for both the young and adult. On the face of it, there's no surprise that it has youth appeal, but if we focus once more on the adult aspects, I think that's where the heart of the film lies. As much as the film deals with the main character fighting his true nature, his inner demons are also fighting the clock. Feeling the pressure of time, Mr. Fox is driven to accomplish his bucket list and fulfill his life.
I don't want to live in a hole anymore. It makes me feel poor.
We are poor, but we're happy.
Comme ci, comme ça.
This may be why he's pushing his luck with the humans, because he senses the end is coming. And what adult doesn't have their moments of questioning life when contemplating how long they've been on this earth? As serious as all of this sounds, Fantastic Mr. Fox is lighthearted on the whole. Its youthful energy is akin to a children's movie, yet there's enough nods to adults to not limit its demographics. By not making its target audience exclusive to children, Fantastic Mr. Fox seamlessly blurs the line with the definition of a family movie and simply makes something enjoyable for all, in the truest sense. Beyond the praised director, the superb casting choices, and the rich aesthetics, this above all things is what makes Fantastic Mr. Fox, indeed, fantastic.